1886 of control.
Get off the phone. Come on, you jerko. Call up George Putman. He'd love to hear from you tomorrow afternoon. Yes, go ahead. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, who's this?
This is Ricky from Beverly Hills.
Yes, Ricky?
Yeah, I have a question. I've been looking all around for your album, and I went into a store, and I asked if they had Wally George, and you know what they brought out?
What did they bring out?
Boy George.
Is that all? Let's call. You're on the air. Hello?
Hello, Wally?
Yeah.
This is Louis Scott from NI Mills.
Yes, what's on your mind?
Do you know those sickle magazines that are out?
The what?
Those girls' sickle magazines that are out. Well, I think they're really, really, really great.
What magazines are you talking about?
Playboy.
Oh, yes. Well, I think they're sick, too, and I'm awfully glad that you called me to tell me that, you little boy. Let's go. Yes, you're on the air. Hello.
Hi, this is Danny from Garden Grove.
Yes, Danny.
And I was wondering, how do you feel about the rising high price of plywood at National Lumber?
Waiting for me out there. Let's hope some semi-rational and sane people are left. Hello, you're on the air.
I just want to know why you think that you have the right to tell everybody what is correct and what is wrong.
Hey, wait a minute. I am telling people what I think is right. I have every right to give my opinion, don't you think?
Not when it's as wrong as it is.
Well, how do you know it's wrong? That's your opinion. I have the right to state my opinion. How do you know that you're right?
You're spreading hatred.
Oh, get out of here. What do you mean how am I spreading hatred?
You're always telling people to hate other people. If they're punkers, you don't like them. If they're homosexuals, you don't like them.
Come on. I am not spreading hatred at all. I am saying what President Reagan is saying. I'm standing up for God and country and morality, my friend. And it happens to be that homosexuality is not a normal, natural way of life in America. It says right in the Bible, man shall not lie with man as he does with woman. It is an abomination. I am not spreading hatred. I am spreading decency and morality and goodness and law and order as the President of the United States is. Now, get off my phone, you little jerkette. Now, let's go to the next caller real fast. You're on the air. Hello.
Oh, I am?
Yes, go ahead, real fast.
Hi, this is Brad, and I was wondering about what you were talking about. Last week, you were talking about the high prices of plywood at National Lumber, and I was wondering that...
I wasn't talking about it. Someone called me about the high price of plywood lumber.
Yeah, Wally, this is Hawk from Huntington Beach.
Yes, sir.
Yes, and I'd like to say, first of all, that I really like your Wally Wally album.
Well, it's very nice of you. Thank you very much. It's doing very well, I understand, for Rhino Records.
Yeah, I'd like to say that I'd like to warn the people of Southern California not to eat your Wally because it smells like dog food.
Uh-huh. Well, aren't you cute? Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Let's go to the... boy. Let's go to the next caller. You're on the air. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, who is this?
Well, yeah, this is Damien from Northridge.
Yes, Davey.
Listen, I just wanted to say that I truly believe that Arnie Evans was the Annie...
All right, that's the end. Arnie Evans was our executive producer. Arnie Evans passed away about a year ago, and you're not going to say anything devious about my former ex, the late Arnie Evans. Yes, your friend Joy is here from Texas Loses, one of the cowgirls. And Joy, come on in here. Lean in here. What do you got for me?
I got a Wally burger.
You got a Wally burger, and there it is. And a chili to go with it.
Yep.
Say hi to Ron for me. Isn't that great?
Hi.
Have you ever seen a burger like that? Thanks a lot, Joy.
Welcome.
Say hi to everybody over there. Fantastic.
Hello.
We're going to have this. We're going to share this with the crew. Thank you so much,
Enjoy.
Joy. Fantastic. We got a Wally burger. Okay. Let's go back to the phones as time permits now. And you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, this is Nancy from Fountain Valley.
Hi, Patsy. I wish I could share the Wally Burger with you.
Okay, I was just wondering, I go to Modern Day High School. Have you heard of it?
Pardon that? Pardon?
Have you heard of Modern Day High School?
Modern Day High School. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to say I do not know of it.
Oh, you don't? Well, we were just wondering, is that your real hair or is it a toupee?
Well, you sweet little jerkette. Thank you so much for calling. Now get off my phone. My line, what does it say in there?
Yep, you're right.
Zachary All. They have great clothes. I'll tell you what, go down there and check that quality. They have great clothes. The same thing that you buy anywhere else, but they buy them in volume, and they have a low overhead. Enough of it. But it's a good place. They really have the good bargains. Zachary All. Say hello to Eddie Nalbanian and Eddie Nalbanian Jr. You're on the air. Hello there.
Hi, Wally. This is Dion Weber of Anaheim.
Yes, what's on your mind, I hope?
I went to Texas Lucy and tried out your Wally Burger.
Well, I'm sure glad you did, and you're off the air because I know it's this character. I recognize his voice. He's trying to get in a little cutie, but thank you very much for calling me, and I'm glad you went to Texas Lucy, and I hope you bought a Wally Burger because they're wonderful, and I know that's what you were going to say, weren't you, pal? You were going to tell me how wonderful the Wally Burger was. I know you were, but I said it for you, so don't worry about it. Now let's go back. Call me again, though, next year at this very same time. Let's go to the next caller. You're on the air. Hello.
Hello, Wally. This is Eugene.
Get off the phone. Did you hear that voice? Come on, let's have some semi-intelligent people on the air. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
This is Arturos. How you doing?
Pretty good. What's on your mind?
Well, first of all, my dad's watching your show and he thinks you're great.
Well, tell your dad, terrific. I appreciate that. He's a very fine man.
Okay. And I've been watching your show for about a year. I think it's great.
Well, terrific.
And, I was just wondering, when you came out of the studio last night around, I guess, 7:30 or 8, well, I saw you looking into a boy's shower room.
All right, all right. Thank you, and say hello to your dad. I'll tell you, do I have to tell you this? Go to the next call. What is wrong? I don't understand it tonight. Let's go. Are you going to be a sane person? Come on the air.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes.
This must be Jerk Friday. Go ahead. Okay, he hung up. He must have realized he was a jerk. Okay, go ahead. I scared the heck out of him. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
This is Kevin Dolan of Marina High School.
Yes, Kevin.
I don't know if you remember me, but I was at your hot seat Saturday night. And
I remember you, Kevin, and thank you for calling me to reminding me about it. Let's go to the next caller. You're on the air. Hello. Yes, hello.
Wally?
Yes.
This is Jeff from Atlanta Park.
Hello, Jeff.
Wally, last Tuesday you said that bestiality is where people that like to have sex with animals.
Yes, well, thank you. I don't want to talk about bestiality because this happens to be dinner time. Boy, oh boy, what's happening tonight. I can't believe this. Let's go to the next caller. Hello, you're on the air. Our phone lines completely with the Big Wally liberal repellent. You're on the air.
Wally, Steve from Arleta.
Hi, Steve.
Hey, I saw you on the People's Court the other day.
Some maniac was picking on Wally, but I won it, didn't I?
Well, yeah, but Judge Wapner, man, he got the best of you.
The best of me?
Oh, come on, Wally.
That little wimp.
He put you down. I couldn't.
Get off my phone.
I want to ask you something.
Get off my phone. No, I'm sorry, you've had it. Judge Wapner, nobody gets the best of Wally. Judge Wapner really is a wimpy little judge, you know that.
What is your educational background? Do you have a BA, an MBA, or a PhD? And what gives you the authority to tell me what to do? What is your educational practice?
I'll tell you why, because I am the greatest...
philanthropist.
Because I am the greatest living American since George Washington. That's what gives me the right, and you should know that. I shouldn't even have to tell you that. Who is a better American than Wally George? You fool. I'll be right back. Don't go away. What a ridiculous question to ask. Everybody knows.
Wally, congratulations on your new number.
Thank you very much. We're very excited about it.
Yeah, well, I'm a former police officer, and I just want to say what a travesty the McMartin School, the court thing is being handled.
Oh, you're so right.
And I was just wondering if you'd play Naked Movie Star with me.
Can you believe that? You are not a former police officer. Don't tell me that. You're a former pervert. Can you imagine trying to sneak through with a thing like that? Don't ask me. Call Brian Lockwood. Okay.
Don't call me.
You're on the air. Go ahead. Yes, you're on the air.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, well, I think you're homo.
All right, get off fast. See, I'm the new number. Where's my liberal repellent? Go ahead, you're on the air. Hello?
Yes.
Go ahead, you're on the air.
Oh, yes. I'd like to say that I really like your...
I don't like your voice. Get off the phone. Yes, go ahead. You're on the air. I can always tell a smart punk when I hear one. Go ahead. You're next. Hello?
I don't believe in Jesus Christ. Does that mean I'll go to hell or something?
I'll tell you what it means, pal. You are so high, I don't know how you could even dial the phone. This guy is flying. Can't you hear it? This guy is out of it. Next caller, you're on the air. Hello? Hey, if you're going to fly on a cocaine or something, don't call me while you're on your trip. Yes, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, I'd like to talk to Wally, please.
You're talking to him. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Oh, hi, this is Kim.
Hello, Kim.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, I just wanted to know if you'd go out with me.
Well, I'll tell you what, Kim. Here's the procedure on that. What you have to do is you have to send a whole biography. Now, which should consist on your entire history, how old you are, you know, where you're from, a whole bio, and send about four or five full color pictures. They find out that there is a house being used to store drugs. I say get that battering ram and knock it down, confiscate the drugs, and throw the drug dealers in jail. It's about time we started to get tough on drug pushers. Any more time? One more call, then we'll take a break. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, you want to buy a gram, Wally?
Not from you, pal. And by the way, we have just traced your phone. Somebody will be knocking on your door in much sun as possible. Certainly they can wear a little string bikini. I mean, the part of the body that is being covered by a little string bikini does not need a suntan. One more call. Let's go ahead. You're on the air. Hello. Oh, that was...
Wally.
Yes.
Grant from Manhattan Beach.
Hi, Grant.
I'm a surfer, and I was wondering what you think I should do about all the crowds coming down. I'm trying to get rid of them. What do you think?
You're a surfer from where?
Manhattan Beach.
You mean all the crowds are coming down and making it miserable on you surfers, right?
They keep taking all our waves, and there's nothing we can do. What do you think?
Boy, I'll tell you, my heart really bleeds for you. I mean, that's one of the real problems in our nation today.
The microphone.
Sorry, man. Sorry. My name is Nick Diederich from Anaheim, and can you see my shirt?
Yes,
it says No Bozos. Man, that means you, Wally.
Get off. No,
that must have been the president.
No, we don't even know.
We don't know, but thank you.
Your fan club.
Hi, Wally.
Yeah.
This is Steve from Redlands.
Hi, Steve.
Hey, you know that last guy with the No Bozo sign?
Yes.
Gosh, I think he's right, because you are a...
And so, when you grow up, call me again sometime. But don't you think Wally should get a little money for this?
A little money?
Yeah.
You want money to be in one of the most well-known comedian magazines? National magazine.
Are you sure you don't work for this magazine?
I do not work for this magazine. I go to my street corner news seller and
you
I
go to your...
this magazine, and I have nothing to do with it. I just love this magazine. I have no connections whatsoever.
So you don't think I should sue them?
Sue them? Sue them? I think you should be paying them.
Oh, get off my phone. Come
oh
on, pay them.
Have...
Get off my phone. You're finished. Are you serious? You're off.
No,
you're off.
I think you're wrong.
Get off. Aren't they listening to me in the booth?
Hey, Wally, how you doing?
Fine, who's this?
This is your old drinking companion. We haven't been out for a drink recently.
Is this Richard Blade?
This is Richard Blade. Cool.
Richard! Now that I have you on the air, is this really the Blade from K-Rock?
It certainly is, Wally.
Now, Blade, you have really gotten me in a lot of trouble because you said on the air, Blade, that I had gone out with you many times socially drinking and that I had a drinking problem. Now is your chance to vindicate me, and I hope you'll be decent enough to go on the air right now and tell my viewers that you were only kidding, that I certainly have not gone out drinking with you. Will you tell them that?
Well, Wally, you don't have a drinking problem. Couple of drinks, you fall down, no problem.
Sean from Newport Beach.
Hello, Sean.
Hey, Wally, I think you should have been aborted.
You sick. I thought we were supposed to use this. Get off my phone, you jerk. Hello.
Senator Robbins proposed to build a strip in Lake Encinitas, in Lake Encinitas, about 15 miles north of Magic Mountain, but was considered too far for racers to travel and was aborted. I would like...
Please don't say the word aborted on my program. I really challenge you to get service at some of these post offices. You stand in line for 4 hours, there's nobody there to wait on you, and you wonder where they are. They're behind that curtain or whatever they have there, chatting and giggling and taking multiple coffee breaks. Okay, why are you wearing the shades, pal?
Take them off?
Go ahead.
All right. In your song, you talk about how heavy metal is like a passing fad.
Right.
The truth is, Ozzy lives in Europe, passing fad. Yeah!
Yeah! Finally, the Herald Examiner has acknowledged Channel 56 as a television station. And
Dave from Sherman Oaks.
Yes, Dave.
Yeah, I just wanted to talk about the length of your penis.
What?
Yeah.
I love your show, and I love your daughter's nice round round.
I beg your pardon? I don't want to hear that one. Okay, can I have a little more volume, please, in the booth, Manny? Yes, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, Wally. This is Jack in San Marino.
Yes, Jeff.
I think Hot Seat is great.
Thank you.
And I really want to say, fuck you.
Second, I have a suggestion. I think when we have people on hold, you ought to trace their phone numbers. And when you get these jerks on the phone to try to cuss them here, you ought to send the battering ram over their house and not...
Hey, that's a good idea. I would also expel immediately students caught using drugs on campus, not just selling them. I would expel them if they're caught using drugs on campus, anywhere in Southern California. That undercover police officers are needed on all school campuses to pinpoint those students who are into drugs. This is a sample copy, and I'm going to be writing a column in that every month. I said, why would you write in a magazine like this? Because I want to take on the enemy. I got to move into enemy territory to win converts.
I got two quick questions for you, Wally.
Yes, sir.
One, do you think that the Soviet Union should have any input into the Middle East negotiations? And two, what kind of hair replacement method do you use?
What was that again? I heard that. On the first question, on the second question, I won't even dignify it. And I went to see Purple Rain just to check it out. It was just revolting. I am no Prince fan. He is really a very bad influence. And then this girl goes on to say, listen to this. She says, I am 14 and I have sex all the time. I say this. Hey, your father should lock you in your room till you're 25.
DeRose from Anaheim Hills.
Yes, Eric.
How you doing?
Okay.
My dad, Ron's watching me. He likes your show.
Oh, Ron, your dad?
Yeah.
How are you, Ron? You're a good man. Now go ahead and ask me your question.
Okay, I like your show, too, and every time,
Tell his... your father should be so ashamed to have a little... pervert like you for a son. I am very sick and tired of those whole Hare Krishna people, you know, running up and down the street with their tambourines and their bells and their shoes.
You could get a switch that you can turn off these jerkettes like the one you had on your show, so you can just cut them off when they start talking their you-know-what.
Yeah, well, they're just lunatics. They're out of their minds, and you got to feel sorry for them.
This is Jonathan Melton from Fountain Valley High School.
Okay, John.
I just want to say, you're number one jerk.
a little fathead. Use readers who they would like to have sex with. Now that's crude. But the only reason I bring that up is they listed some people, and guess who is in there? The write-ins. Ronald Reagan, Michael Jackson, Debbie Allen, and Wally George. Showed up on the pole. I don't know. Go ahead.
Hey, Wally, how you doing?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Pretty good.
Who's this?
This is Arturo from Adam Hills.
Yes, sir.
You got a great show, and I've been watching you for about a year.
Well, bless your little heart.
And your mom was calling.
Yeah, boy, you see. Oh, boy, I'd like to get him by his little earlobe. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Well, this is Jim from Costa Mesa.
Yes, Jim.
How are you doing today?
I hope you're semi-sane.
Yes, I'm semi-sane.
Very good. Go ahead.
Yeah, Wally, my wife and I, we watch you every night, and we'd first just like to congratulate you.
Thank you.
On the success and, I would suppose, conquest, too, of your first direction with Mary.
Well, did you get that? Go ahead, Jill.
Well, I want to tell you that in this democratic society we have, it's great, but people, you know, they got shows like yours where you're so communist, you don't let anybody talk. You know, and you're really rude to people. I just want to tell you, this is the worst show I've ever seen. Bye.
Am I going to go to the flash dance?
Yeah.
No, didn't you listen to me? I'm going to Cal State Northridge tonight. Pay attention.
Well, anyway, the Hags are playing, and you should go see them.
The Hags?
Yeah.
The Hags are playing where?
In Anaheim at Flashdance.
Hey, here's a public service message to all the people of Southern California. The Hags are playing at Flashdance. Stay away from there.
Is there anything that you disagree with Ronald Reagan about?
Nothing. Oh, yes, there is one thing I disagree with Ronald Reagan about. He did not care too much for the picture Bedtime for Bonzo. I thought it was better than Gone with the Wind. On the poll in the register on the Orange County sex poll,
yes.
You were not listed, Richard.
I was upset about that. But Wally, the thing is, I know the guy that wrote your name in.
Who is that? Oh, wait! Get off my phone. It was probably you, you nut. All right, Blake, get off my phone.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
How you doing?
Fine, who is this?
Eric Gross from Nine Hills.
What's on your mind, Eric?
Well, you got a great show and everything, and I've been watching it for about a year. And
great.
Those guys you had on the show today were really jerks, I think they were.
Yeah. Yeah. Who was on today again? Who was on the best
Wally.
Of Oxy? Huh?
Wally?
Yes.
Well, I just want to say, you're so ugly, you give my dog diarrhea.
Mental midgets again.
I think your show is really good, and, you know, I think you're doing a really good job.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah, but I was wondering where you picked up that wig.
Same where you picked up that cheap brain. Come on, you idiot. How many times do you get the... Is that all you can think about? Do I have to go through this day?
This is Teresa.
Yes, Teresa, what's on your mind? Get off the phone. Let's go to the next caller. You're on the air. Hello.
Yeah.
Yes, who's this?
This is Dan.
Yes, Dan.
Who's this?
This is Wally. What's on your mind?
Hey, Wally. I watch the show every day. It's a great show. I'm just wondering how you ever got on TV. You're the most obnoxious.
You're on the air. Hello.
Is this Wally George?
Yes, who's this?
I like to say you're an asshole, man.
Like, I go to a college where they have us go to different meetings in my religious group.
Yes.
One of the meetings was a group of atheists, and they were giving us... Do you know what their best reason why they don't believe there's a God is?
What is it?
They said that if there was a God, how could he make anybody who wore such a lame toupee like you?
Hello, Wally George.
Yes.
This is David Schmall from Anaheim Hills.
Hello, Dave. What's on your mind?
I just wanted to tell you, first of all, I have a lot of your products, such as the video cassette and the Wally Wally album.
And you like them, I hope?
Oh, yeah, I love them.
That's terrific.
But I think those are great products, but I think that to improve this kind of business, I think that you should market a Wally wig.
Do you really think so? Gee, that's cute of you to say. That was hilarious. I bet it took you about 5 days to think that up. Get off, you little jerk. Wasn't he cute? Oh, they're so adorable, these little five-year-olds who get on the phone. I love them all.
Hello, Wally George.
Who's this?
This is David Schmall from Anaheim Hills.
David from Anaheim Hills. We got a lot of Anaheim Hillites watching us. What's on your mind today?
Well, about a month and a half ago, I tried to call up because I thought I saw you in the parking lot of a store. And I...
Well, it's possible. I do once in a while go shopping.
Well, I called you,
This is a very inspiring call. Yes, go ahead.
You kind of turned around, but I wasn't sure if it was you.
Uh-huh.
And you were going... I was going to the hardware store, and you were... Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
And you were going out of this porno store buying pornos.
Oh, is that right? Gee, I'm
sure
glad you told the world. Get off the phone! Hello, you're on the air, yes?
Hello, Wally?
Yes.
I'd like to say that...
Well, I'm glad you said it. Hello, you're on the air, yes. Turn your television down. Hello?
Yes.
Who's this?
I'd like to talk to Wally George.
You're talking to him. Go ahead.
Well, I can see you down there. I'm not talking to you. You're not talking to me.
Stupid. You're on 10-second tape. How many times do I have spent to tell you this?
I was wondering if you'd like Tom Bradley a little more if he were white.
Oh, you sick pervert. Are you trying to hint that maybe Wally is a little bit of a racist?
He is.
Well, he is not. You're talking to me, jerko.
I wanted to know what you thought when your daughter told you that she was going to pose nude in the movie Risky Business.
Listen, punk, she didn't pose nude in Risky Business. But I'll bet you do all the time, probably prancing up and down.
Wally,
the... Yes.
I really like your troll, but I got a problem.
What's your problem?
What's wrong with these rock...
Well...
Like rock houses, you know, like you should be listening to music anywhere. You can have a jazz house, a country house, maybe even a Wally George house.
What are you talking about?
Rock houses, you don't like them. I say they're good music.
Rock house... Rock houses, stupid, are not places where they play rock and roll music. Why don't you ever read the newspaper?
Yes, I'd like to say that I think you're just fantastic.
I want to tell you that you're a phony and get off my phone. Get out of here. He's trying to do an impersonation of George Putnam and a very bad one. Hello, you're on the air. Hello.
Yes, my name's Bill from Irvine.
Yes, Bill.
Yes, and I watch a show on occasion when I get a chance.
On occasion? Get off my phone.
John, and I have a question. What do you think we should do about all this violence on TV? I mean, there's not enough. I mean, I think it's really great.
There's not enough violence on TV?
Yeah.
You little punk jerk. Get off my phone.
But I like you. What are you going to do for president when you're president in 88?
What am I going to do?
Yeah.
Well, first of all, I'm not going to talk to nitwits like you. You can't build too many planes for me or too many missiles. We got to keep them rolling, Charlie.
I wanted to comment on that Timothy Leary guy.
Yeah, isn't he a nut?
That guy's a jerk. By the way, I think you're a bigger
Oh, are you back again, you nitwit? Get off my phone. Don't try to tell me my religion. I know what I'm saying. It's a shame you don't, you jerkette. I really do appreciate you calling all the way from Bel Air. You know, that's our first Bel Air call. Hope it's not the last. Feel free, wherever you do live in Bel Air, feel free to invite me over for dinner sometime. I'd love to come over.
What do you think of those immoral X-rated film producers who are always constantly trying to get your daughter?
I think you probably need a very, very complete brain examination, a brain scan. I suggest that you go tomorrow morning at your earliest convenience.
I wonder what you think about the Santa Monica Mountains being torn up and heroin addicts like Ted Knight moving in and taking over all the land.
Oh, well, you know what I think. The Santa Monica Mountains being torn up, it's a communist plot. That's what it is, and I'm going to look into it. I just did look into it, and it's terrible. I'll look into it. Hello?
Wally?
Yeah, who's this?
Norm LeBeau.
Norm LeBeau? What are you doing calling me, you slime?
This is Jeff Clark from Cyprus.
Yes, Jeff.
I just want to say how much I enjoy your show.
All right.
And that you're a stupid bitch.
Uh-huh. Well, it certainly, we did catch him, didn't we? Hello.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
This is Eric from Granada Hills.
Okay, Eric.
I'd like to know your comments about you jerking off backstage.
All right. Yeah. Hit the button on that, moron. You idiot. Go back to your playpen, you...
This is Michelle from Los Angeles.
All right, Michelle, what's on your mind?
I finally got around to hearing your Wally Wally album.
Well, did you like it?
It was the worst experience of my life.
Well, let me tell you something. This telephone call is the worst experience of my life, so that makes us even. Get off the phone, you jerkette. Hello, you're on the air. We are born in the image of God, but some do not stay in that image, and they do stray into jerkland.
Hey, Wally!
Who's this?
This is Michelle from Los Angeles.
Hi, Michelle.
How are you?
Fine.
Great.
What's on your mind, dear?
Why don't you get a toupee with some brains?
This is Randy.
Okay, Randy, go ahead.
Yeah, I was wondering what you thought about the death penalty.
Get off. What have you been doing? I've been talking about that for the past hour, you nitwit. Pay attention. Turn your hearing aid up or turn your brain up or something. What's the matter with you people? Are you all on acid? Yes, next caller, you're on the air.
Yeah, I want to know what you feel about the death penalty.
absolute maniacs. You're on the air, hello.
Hey, Wally.
Yes.
This is Pete from Anaheim.
By the way, to that last person who just called, if you ever get up there, I'll pull the lever.
I just turned into your show, and I was wondering, what do you feel about the death penalty?
My name is Kyle.
Okay, Kyle.
And I wanted to say that I heard that Gene Scott gave you AIDS.
You got that, I hope.
What are you doing?
Wait. My name. Hey, can I talk? Hey, you. I squeeze your head, all right?
Hello.
Yes.
Is this Wally's?
Certainly is. Who's this?
This is Chuck.
Yes, Chuck. What's on your mind, I hope? Goodbye. You mental retards out there who think you can sneak something through on me. We have Dick in master control with his finger on the button. And if you think you can get anything past us, you are crazy. Don't even try.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
This is EP of Granada Hills.
Okay.
I would like to know what you think about the public wanting to fuck your daughter.
Good. Did we get him?
They always get them all.
Get them all. Yes, you're on the air. Hello.
Yeah, good evening, Wally. This is Chad from Irvine.
Yes.
How are you doing tonight?
We just had a mental midget on a few moments ago. I hope you will be a little more classy.
Yeah, I think you better spray the line.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, Wally, I wanted to ask you a question about one of your commentaries you'd given the other day, and it deals with President Reagan.
Okay.
You had made mention to President Reagan only currently receiving semi-annual erections as of yourself. And I was wondering what you're going to do to remedy that.
What was that again?
Well, you had made reference the other day to President Reagan only receiving semi-annual erections now.
Hey, we did chop him, I hope, on that.
As long as they always chop
what
him.
Kind of morons do we have out there? What is the matter with you, you... Well, thank you very much. Thank you. Well, Wally couldn't be here tonight. Nancy and I are going to do the best we can. Well, thank you very much. Stay tuned now for a bunch of schlock called the zoo. Oh, boy. Oh.
Hi, Wally. This is Ralph Sellers of Granada Hill.
Real fast, you have 30 seconds.
Yeah, and I think you're too harsh on us gays.
You think I'm too harsh on you gays? Well, I'm so sorry, sweetheart. I'll try to be nicer to you next time you call. Bye. Boy! Thanks for calling, darling. Oh, can you imagine that? Go back to West Hollywood in your little...
Who that was who we just had on the Best of Hot Seat? That is the new mayor of West Hollywood, the admitted lesbian.
And I'd like to ask you, I am a high school student, currently in high school, and I have been all the years, for 10 years, the past 10 years.
For 10 years? You've been in high school? Get off my show. You are too stupid to be on my program. 10 years? Isn't this fun? It's better than watching the stupid local slanted news.
I am for censorship, and I'm censoring you right now. Get out of here!
People make fun of you because you have a picture of Ronald Reagan on the cover of your book. Do not take it off. In fact, do them one better. Keep your picture of Ronald Reagan, and on the other part of your notebook, put a picture of Wally George, and then you'll really be a great American, and you tell your friends who make fun of you to take a flying heap.
A drunk driver comes up behind me going estimated 75 to 80 miles an hour. I never saw the car. If Dr. Ruth can do it, why can't Wally, huh?
What can I do for you tonight?
Who are you?
Pardon?
Who are you?
By George, by Wally, it is ringing. Let's go to the first caller. Hello, you're on the air. Hello?
Yes, Wally?
Yes. Get off. What a ridiculous way to start this program. No, but I can tell by the tone of your squeaky little voice that you certainly are. Go back where you came from. West L.A. misses you. West Hollywood, I should say. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
This is Alan Herrera from Gardena.
Can I have a little more fullback, Bucky, please? Yes, yes, go ahead.
Hello, this is Alan Herrera from Gardena.
Yes, Alan.
When you become mayor, I'm going to...
Get off my... What's going on here? Give me some decent people. I want a decent person. Hello, you're on the air. Hello.
Wally?
Yes, go ahead. Who is this?
This is Greg from Los Angeles.
Greg from Los Angeles. Go ahead.
I want to ask you a question about Pope. Are you virgin?
Oh, boy. You know, I can hardly hear the calls, guys. Can I have a little more in my ear? Yes, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hello, this is Wally.
Yeah, that's fine, guys. Yes, go ahead.
This is Josh from Orange.
Yeah. Have you got a decent question for me?
Yes, I do.
Okay, go ahead.
Do you enjoy being the Antichrist?
Boy, I'll tell you. Do you really think that... Do you think you're cute or something? You're sick. Give me a... Can I have one person who is sane out there? Hello, you're on the air. Who is this? Hello?
This is Chris Jones from Burbank.
Yes, Chris.
And?
Yes?
You listening to me?
I'm listening to you. What do you want to say?
Yeah, this is Chris Jones from Burbank.
I heard what... Get off my phone. Get off. I heard you, you nitwit. It's the second time. This is Chris Jones from Burbank. Big deal.
Hello?
Yes.
Is it true that you're gay?
Oh, boy. Is it true that you have left the human race? Hello, you're on the air. Hello.
Hey, Wally, this is Larry from Pasadena.
Yes?
I was wondering if you're gay.
Muchísimas gracias.
Hey, let's get some decent people on the phone. I'm getting sick and tired of this now. We're not playing games, you idiots. Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, Wally, this is David from Glendale.
Yes, David.
I was wondering if that was your real face.
Oh, boy.
Hey, Wally, this is Scott from Glendale.
Yes.
You're ugly.
Oh, get off. Get off, you little...
Gabe from Anaheim.
Yes, Gabe?
Yeah, do you wash your hair in toilet water?
Oh, boy, you are such a nut. Why waste valuable time asking such ridiculous, asinine things, you stupid little nut? Don't get me mad. Give me somebody decent. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, Wally, this is Ruben from Anaheim.
Yes?
Yes. I watch your show all the time.
Yes?
And I think it really sucks.
I knew it. Three in a row. I want a good caller now, or I'm going to sit here and just stare at you for 30 minutes and not talk to anybody.
Hello, Wally. This is Mike from Huntington Beach.
Yes, Mike.
And I was just wondering if you gave Rock Hudson AIDS.
Oh, boy. Is that sick? You little pimple-faced pervert.
Yeah.
How old are you, Tim?
Oh, I'm 11.
You're 11?
Yeah.
Have you got something decent to say to Wally?
Yeah.
What do you want to say to Wally? What? What do you... Oh, I see. The guy...
William Sapphire is pretty much a conservative. What did he have to say on Donna Hugh today?
Well, he said that you gave your daughter AIDS.
Get off.
Hey, Wally.
Yeah, who's this?
This is Mark. How you doing?
Fine. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just wanted you to know that I slept with your daughter last night.
Grab him. Hey, pal, if you were to come over here and say that to my face about my daughter, I would knock every one of your teeth down your stupid, lousy throat. Did you hear me? Now, come over and say that to my face. I dare you. Don't ever pick on my daughter on my program. If you have any guts, come over here and say it to her father's face, you stupid pervert. Next caller, you're on the air. Yes?
During the aftershock earthquake, I was just wondering if you're with...
Yeah. Next caller, hello. Are we screening these calls? Hello, yes, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yes. What do you want?
Yeah.
Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Wally Jewers. This is Vinny Ballone from Newport Beach.
All right.
I'm from Newport Beach.
Good. I'm glad you're from Newport Beach. Get off my phone. Why do I care where you're from Newport Beach? What are you, bragging that you got a beach house or something? Big
usted
deal.
Usted es muy amable.
That's right. And I'll... Hello, you're on the air. Hello?
Wally.
Yes.
Wally from Anaheim.
Yes.
Will you...
Get off. Give me a serious caller. I want a serious caller right now. Give me a serious caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Muchísimas gracias.
You're welcome. Hello, you're on the air.
Is it true?
Get off. I can tell right away. Give me a serious... It's not funny. Give me a serious caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Is this Wally?
Yes.
Hi, this is Jim from Tustin.
Hi, Jim.
Okay, you'll agree on me on this. Jim...
Joe from Long Beach?
Yes, Joe.
I think you're...
All right, Joe. Thank you for calling, you little twit. We don't care what you think. Go back into your crib and suck your thumb. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Wally?
Yes.
This is Mike from Placentia.
What do you want to talk about?
I just want to know if you're a messy baby.
Oh, boy. Boy, where are all these little babies coming? Give me an adult. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Wally?
Yes.
Me and my friend Baron, we watch you every day. And
yes.
You're really rad, but we want to know how long it takes you to get your hair like that.
Hello?
Yes, who's this?
Hi, this is Jim.
How old are you, Jim?
I'm 14.
You're 14? Call me back in about 12 years,
I think
Jim.
Stopped.
Thank you, Jim. Call me back in about 12 years. Hello, you're on the air. Hello?
Hello, Wally.
Who's this?
This is Dana.
Hi, Dana.
Hi, you suck, Wally.
All right. The sickos are out tonight. Gia, get me some decent callers for the next segment, or I'm going to just walk off in disgust and leave this place with nobody sitting here.
Wally?
Yes, who's this?
Mike.
Yes, Mike, go ahead.
I was wondering about the Gulf and the mine.
The who?
The mine and the Gulf.
In the mine and the gold?
Oh,
fuck off.
Okay, thanks for calling. I don't understand what he's talking about. Hello.
Oh, Wally, this is Mike from Huntington Beach.
Yes, Mike.
And I was just curious what you thought about that ugly bimbo of your daughter.
Oh, come on. Talk about my daughter, one of the most gorgeous female creatures ever created in mankind. You jealous little pervert.
Hi, Wally. This is Carmen from Chapman College.
What do I talk about, Carmen? Never mind the I can't... Don't ever say Whenever you say I know you're up to something. Don't say Just say it. Don't say You know how stupid that sounds on the air? Hello, you're on the air.
I need to ask Wally a question.
Go ahead. What do you want to ask? What's the question?
I want to know what the main purpose of this show is.
The main purpose of this show is to get idiots like you off the air. And we just accomplished it. What do you think the main purpose of this show is? Haven't you been watching it? Why do you ask me a crazy question like that?
Ollie?
Yeah, who's this?
This is Kristen from Laguna.
Hi, Kristen.
I want to know your opinion on something.
What is that?
Is your face as white as your butt?
Get off my show. Was that a little girl? Was that a little... Why, your mother should spank your bottom, you stupid little girl. When the stock market goes real high for a long time, there's got to be a period of adjustment. And this was our period of adjustment. Things had to level off. Okay, let's go to our next caller. Hello, you're on. Hey, don't do that, guys. If it doesn't make any sense, come on. Do something that makes sense, but don't do something that doesn't make any sense. Hello. Hello, you're on. Don't play games in there. What's John doing? Is he drinking in there or something? Hello, you're on the air.
Oh, Wally.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
This is Josh from Orange.
Yes, Josh.
What condiment do you recommend?
Oh, boy. Hey, I'll tell you what I'll recommend one for you. One that'll fit over your head.
I am not prepared to pussyfoot around any longer.
That's right. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yes. Well, say something, you nitwit! Boy, oh boy. Don't get me teed off. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Wally.
Yes.
This is Eric from Huntington Beach.
So?
What do you think?
Goodbye. Yeah. Hello, you're on the air.
Wally.
Yes.
This is Frank from Cynthia.
What's on your mind?
I just want to know if you smell. Oh.
Easy to apply, dries quickly, and brings new beauty to interior floors, woodwork, trim,
listen,
doors, and furniture.
I'm warning you right now. I'm not putting up with you idiots. You want to play games? I'll just sit here and stare into the camera for half an hour. I'm not here to play games, you stupid nitwits. Now give me a decent caller. Hello? Hello, who is this?
This is Ken from Anaheim.
Have you got a decent question?
Yeah.
What is it?
It's about heavy metal.
Well, okay, I'll answer it. Hang up on him because I don't want him to say anything anymore. He asked me a question, I'll answer it. I've said it 100 times and I'll say it again. There's nothing wrong with heavy metal as long as it is not satanic, as long as it is not promoting drugs and perversion, as long as it is not promoting and encouraging the kind of nitwits that call on this program and make pit bulls have gotten a bad rap. And I say, I don't think it's so much the pit bulls, I think it's their owners. They haven't trained them right. Just like some parents don't train their children right. And they call me the nitwits, the bad parents who don't know how to train their babies right. They put them in a room and hand them a telephone. Yeah, yeah, these parents, they put their imbecile children in their cribs and hand them a phone and say, call Wally. Yeah, so that they won't bother them for a while. Well, I'm tired of being babysitter from 4:30 to 5. Take care of your own brats.
Yes, Wally.
Get off the air. Next caller. Hello, you're on the air. Hello.
Hello, Wally?
Yes.
It's Mike Queen from Placentia.
Goodbye, Mike. You're on the air.
Hi, Wally. This is Valerie. I'm calling from El Toro. And
yes, Valerie.
And I just want to know, how long have you been wearing a wig?
I was listening to Rick Steves today.
What'd he say about me?
He said you guys are fags.
Get off. Next caller, you're on the air.
What?
Get him off it. Did that guy burp on the air? You stupid nincompoop. Don't you ever do that. Can you imagine that?
Oh, Wally.
Yes.
It's Josh from Orange.
Yes, Josh?
I have a decent question today.
I hope so.
Where do you buy your panties?
Oh,
hey, this is Greg Burkhart from Seattle, Washington.
Oh, you're watching on the big satellite.
Yeah, watching on the satellite.
How's it coming in?
It's coming in pretty good, but there's something hanging out of your nose.
Oh, get out of here. Get him off of there, stupid moron. Christ. I should have known better. They're all ill up there. Jesus. Hello, you're on the air. Hello.
Yeah, Wally.
Yes.
This is Kevin from Brea.
Yes, Kevin.
And I want to know what you think of Wally George toilet paper.
Boy, you know what? Talk about sickness. Sickness. Sickness.
Yeah, Wally, this is Tom Lowe from Orange.
Yes, sir?
Smoke them all, Wally.
This is Mike McCormick from Newport Beach.
Yes, Mike.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
Hey, you know, I go out and I get my newspaper this morning. I get my breakfast. I make a nice hot breakfast. And what do I see? Some homosexual gets custody of some other homosexual's kid now.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I don't know what's more sick, you know. Being gay or having a hippie haircut like you?
Oh, all right, now let me, never mind. Let me comment on that story, you little punk. I think you're smart, trying to sneak in something on me. We knew. Yes.
Boy.
Yes, yes.
This is Mark from Fullerton.
Thanks for calling, Mark. Nice hearing from you. And a very Merry Christmas to you. Hello, you're on. Max, you're on the air. Hello?
Where'd you get the wig?
Get out of here. Get him out of here. Next caller. Set up the next victim. You're on the air. Hello, next, you're on the air.
You're an idiot.
That's it. Get him out of there.
I wanted to let you know that I had a heavy metal band going, and I thought we named a song after Wally.
Oh, yeah? What's the name of the song?
It's called Wally's a Dweeb.
Get out of here. Wally's a Dweeb. What's a dweeb? A geek?
Wally.
Yes. Oh, boy. Don't tell me we're in for another little... Can't I... You know how stupid you're making this program? You know what I'm going to do? If this continues, I'm going to walk the hell off of this show. I'm not going to do the damn thing. I'm not going to sit here and talk to a bunch of imbeciles. If this continues, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to walk off the damn show. I'm not going to do this. You see, on KLAC, I don't have to put up with you idiots. I have a producer on KLAC who doesn't let you get through. But if you're going to continue to behave like maniacs, I'm not going to do this program because it's not worth it to me. Now, if you can't call me and talk like decent human beings, then what the hell am I doing here? I'm not here to listen to you every day for a half an hour, make complete jackasses out of yourself. I have more important things to do. If you're going to continue to behave like this, and if we can't screen the calls to get decent people on this show, then to hell with this program, I will leave it. Hello, you're on the air.
You want to walk off the show, you big...
Next caller, hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Wally, this is Orrin from Chapman College.
Yes, go ahead, Orrin.
Yeah, I was watching a news program the other day about Ginsburg smoking marijuana, and it occurred to me I was getting high with your daughter.
Oh, yeah, oh, boy, I'll tell you. You're getting, it's getting close, it's getting very close. Hello, next caller, you're on the air.
Yeah, well, you're a pinhead.
Give me another caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Why are you so ugly?
Give me another caller.
Hey, Wally.
Yeah?
How's it going?
Get off my show.
Wait.
I'd like to see one of you pinheads come down and sit here and take the kind of baloney that I have to take from a bunch of little tiny twerp maniac pimp heads, or whatever you call them. You think it's funny? You think people at home like to hear a bunch of morons babbling on? This program is here to talk about the issues. Why don't you realize and grow up? Grow up! Don't be little babies. It's not funny. It's tragic that that's all you have to do with your life. You got nothing else better to do than to call up and blabber and behave like a nitwit? Is that all you have in your life to do? I feel sorry for you. That's all you have to entertain yourself. Next caller, you're on the air.
Is your wig from your mother?
Was that a good...
Wally.
Yes.
This is Curtis Mannheim.
Yes, sir.
Is it true that you can get AIDS from eating a Wally burger?
Oh, boy, oh, boy. You really want to get stupid today, huh? You really want to get nuts and stupid. Hello?
Wally, this is Tom calling you from Orange.
Yes, Tom?
I want to talk about that gypsy character you had on Saturday night.
The female impersonator.
Yeah, that guy's a real psycho. I think he's the funniest guy I've ever seen. And even if I wasn't stoned, it'd be funny.
Yeah, you sound like you're stoned, you little nitwit. Now go back and take a big drag on your joint and then turn yourself in to mommy.
I believe the Wally burger has Swiss cheese on top.
It does have Swiss cheese on top.
And the Swiss cheese is white, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, is that so it'd be the same color as your wig?
Get off. Same color as my wig. This is not a wig. When are you going to believe that this is my own... Listen, I will be perfectly happy to make private appointments with you nitwits to come down and inspect my scalp. Now look, Mike, can you see my... Come over here, Mike. On camera. You can see my scalp, right?
Yeah.
Is that my hair?
Yeah.
You see, it's my hair. Okay, thank you, Mike. Now you see, Mike's inspected my scalp, and there it is. Look at there. It's my hair. Do I have to be embarrassed like this on Thanksgiving Day? Let's go to the next caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Fine, who's this?
Hi, this is Jim.
Hello, June?
Jim.
Oh, Jim. How are you, Jim?
Fine. I just want to say Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
You're a big pup.
Okay, thank you, Jim. Happy Thanksgiving to you. We caught him fast. You little... Don't pick up Gia! What is this? You little morons. That's right, Gia. That's right. Next caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yeah, who's this?
Who's this?
Hello, Wally?
Yeah, who's this?
This is Greg.
And Kevin.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year. All right. Get out of here. Get off. Get him off. What the heck are you smoking? Or snorting, or both. Who's this?
This is Matt.
Yes, Matt, what's on your mind today?
I want to talk about Reagan.
What about Reagan?
His meeting with Gorbachev.
And what do you think about it?
I think it sucks.
Get off. You little pervert. How dare you say that? Oh.
Hello, Wally. I think you should get rid of your wig.
You're wasting all of our time. This is nonsense. Hello, you're on the air.
Oh, Wally, this is Orb from Chapman College.
Yes, Orb?
Yeah, I'm just, I was watching this movie about Gandhi last week, and I was looking at this scrawny little bald-headed guy, and it looked like you.
I knew that was coming. I could tell by his stupid, moronic voice, but you know what? I wanted to give him his 15 seconds of fame. As Andy Warhol once said, everybody has 15 seconds in the spotlight. You just had yours, pal. You'll never get it again. Next caller, you're on the air.
Hi. Thanks to deregulation with President Reagan is the reason that you're having the trouble with... The reason that you're having the trouble...
Oh, never mind. Get off. You can't even talk straight. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Wally.
Who's this?
I don't know. What do you want me to be?
Hello?
Hey, Wally.
Yeah.
This is Greg Burkhardt from Denver, Colorado.
Oh, are you watching me on the big dish?
I'm watching on the satellite, and it's coming in loud and clear.
Glad to hear from you. How are things in Denver today?
It's very, very cold.
Oh, man.
Muchísimas gracias.
Let me see. It's about,
about 4 below?
Oh, it's about 31.
Oh, my God.
31 degrees today.
Well, what's on your mind today from Denver?
What's something hanging out of your nose?
Thanks for calling from Denver. Talk to me. Hello.
Hello, Wally.
Yeah, who's this?
This is John from San Clemente.
What do you want to talk about, John?
I just want to... Oh, before I get to my question, I went to Tustin Honda.
Yes.
And I bought a Wally... I said Wally George sent me.
Yeah?
They raised the price $300.
Get off. Get off my show. They raised the price $300. Are you crazy, you little nitwit? Raise the price. Hey, for you, they shouldn't even sold it to you, no matter what the price. They only sell their bikes at Tustin Honda to real Americans. Obviously, you're a nitwit, twerp, pervert, commie pinko. Hello, you're on the air. Hello. Good Lord. The guy's going to OD any second. He's really snorting a lot of it today. Hello, you're on the air.
Yes, I'd like to ask Wally, what do you think about the persecution of skateboarders?
Hello!
Wasn't your daughter in a blood...
Oh, get off, get off, get off, get off, get off! You're bothering me. Hello, you're on the air. Hello.
Wally.
Yes?
What do you think about Mr. Stocks in Anaheim? Where'd you get the obvious wig?
Oh, get off, get off. See these little... Wally, you know how they come on and they talk real fast? They're trying to squeeze in something, you know. But I'll squeeze them out before they do.
Wally.
Yes?
This is Mike from Fountain Valley.
Hi, Mike.
My parents just named my brother after you. He was retarded.
Oh, get off my show. Don't try to be smart with me, you little punk.
This is Josh from Orange.
Yes, Josh?
Did you hear Bruce Babbitt say that you guys are bed buddies?
Well, get off my show, you stupid. Right off the bat, we have some moron. Are you crazy? Santa agrees with me on that. Don't say bad things about Santa. What's the matter with you? Merry Christmas from Norm Epstein and all the people at KLAC. We'll go back to our final... Yes, Santa, right, wonderful you. Let's go to the next caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
Hi, it's Omar from Santa Ana.
Who?
Omar.
Omar from Santa Ana.
How are you?
Omar, I have strange feelings about you, Omar. I have strange feelings about Omar.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
Yeah, I'd like to make a comment.
What? Get off. Grab him by the nose and lead him into the manure pit where he belongs. Hello, you're on the air.
Wally?
Yes.
Hi, this is John from Anaheim.
Yes, John.
You should wear a Santa...
Oh, get off. Don't bother me. Will you stop aggravating me? This is supposed to be a serious show 2 days before Christmas, you nitwit. We're trying to spread love around here, you raunchy maniac. Don't you know what I'm here to do? To spread love. Right? Let's spread some love around here.
Oh, Wally.
Who's this?
Omar from Santa Ana.
What's on your mind, Omar?
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Week.
Oh, that does it. That does it. You dirty, no good little perverts. Go stick your head in your Christmas tree and turn the lights on. Stand in water when you do it. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Wally.
Yes.
This is Josh Morge.
Yes. Oh, no, Josh. Oh, no, I know you, Josh. You're out. I know that sickening, depraved, perverted little voice. Now, you can't get by. You've tried too many times. You're out of here, Josh. I know that voice.
Wally.
Yes. Hello.
Hello, Wally.
Yes, what's on your mind today?
All right, first of all, I just want to wish you a Happy New Year.
Same to you, pal.
And then I want to say that I watch your show every day.
Good for you.
All right, nitwit.
Hi, Wally.
Yeah.
This is John Holmes from Tustin.
Hi, John.
And I hate your show.
Thank you. I'm so glad you called. Isn't that nice? That was terrific. Nice to hear from you. Hey, why don't you come down, say hello to Wally so I can knock all your teeth out.
Hey, this is Andrew from Santa Monica.
Hi, Andrew.
Hey, how you doing, George?
Good. Wally is the name.
It was hard to get a hold of you.
What's that?
Who said it was hard to get a hold of you?
Everybody.
Well, listen,
get out of here. Next caller, hello, you're on the air.
Hey, Wally.
Yes.
This is Phil. I'm calling from Orange.
Yes, Phil.
I just wanted to say that I'm really into you. I've been into you. I'm in the Army now, so I haven't been able to be into you for a while now, but...
And we're going to be televising my wedding live on Channel 56 and all over the world.
Wally. Well, this is Ben from Orange.
Ben from Orange. How old are you, Ben?
14.
14. Do you think you're old enough to talk to Wally?
Yes. You're get not... off my show, nipple!
I knew it. You see, you stupid little twerp, crawl back in your cradle and suck your thumb for a few more hours until Mommy comes home. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Wally.
Who's this?
Is your wife a bitch?
Thank you so much for calling, and a Happy New Year to you.
Hey, Wally?
Yes?
This is Vance from Laguna.
Yes, Vance?
First thing, where do you get off?
I get off on the corner of Sunset and Vine. Where do you get off? Isn't that about right? Sunset and Vine. Sometimes I get off on Hollywood and Highland.
Trying to get together a league, you know, more like a club, to keep down prostitution in L.A., and we came up with this idea. Tell me what you think of it.
Okay.
It's about keeping down prostitution. We figured the best way is to keep your daughter off the...
Get off. Don't... You see, they got to get out. When are you going to stop taking pot shots at my daughter, you nitwit? My daughter happens to be a lady, and you'll never, ever be able to date one. The only people you'll be able to date are the weirdos on Santa Monica Boulevard with earrings in their ears. Hello?
This is Walt calling via satellite from Madison, Wisconsin.
Hello there, Madison, Wisconsin. Come in.
Yeah, Wally.
What's on your mind?
Actually, this is Josh from Orange.
Josh from Orange?
Yeah.
How dare you call me? Get off. Didn't I tell you you're banned from this program for 5 years?
Yeah, hi, this is VJ from Cerritos.
Who?
VJ.
VJ?
Yeah.
How old are you, VJ?
I'm 14.
14. And what do you want to talk to Wally about?
Yeah, first of all, I'd like to congratulate you on your upcoming marriage.
Thank you.
And I've been watching your show for 3 years, and I'd like to know if it is true that you have a lawsuit against KNAC, you idiot.
KNAC? Did you call Wally an idiot?
This is Greg Burkhardt from Tacoma, Washington.
How are you, Greg?
I'm fine.
What's on your mind?
What's going on?
What's on your mind today?
Well, your girlfriend's a lesbian.
Hey, are you drinking?
Being.
Wait a minute. Are you drunk? Are you drinking? You are, aren't you? You've been drinking and listening to Wally.
Yeah, Wally.
Yes.
Did you see the Oprah Winfrey show today?
Yeah, we just talked about that. What have you been doing? Snorting something? Get off, you moron. Your brain is probably fried already, I'm sure. We just talked about that. Why don't you pay attention to your television set? Let's call it. You're on the air. Hello? Hello? Someone's really, really gone off the deep end. Get off! Off the deep end. Real. Let's have a real caller now.
Wally.
Yes.
This is Steve Arish calling from Villa Park.
What's on your mind, Steve?
Wait, hold on a second, Wally. I gotta smoke my joint.
Oh, get off! Hold on. Smoke your joint, you perverted, pot-headed freako. Next caller, you're on the air.
Hello, Wally?
Swine. Hey, why don't you put your head in the toilet and flush it? Hello, you're on the air. That's where it belongs. And that's where your brain is, so why don't you put your whole face in there? Hello, you're on the air. Yes. Hello?
Well, this is Steve from Upland.
Yes, Steve.
Yeah, I think, you know, about Ronald Reagan not getting aired.
Huh?
Yeah. I think, hey.
Oh, you mean Ronald Reagan's speech not getting on the three networks?
Yeah.
What did you think about that?
Hey, I think it's right, you know, if the networks don't want to listen to his trash.
Oh, get off, you moron.